Hello, my name is Ramon Yeni from Yeni Science, and in this video we are going to set the basic parameters of the CNext state controller for an application. After this video, you should know what payload, gain current and gain pause, deviation position and target, and also what the advanced settings means, like stability, avoid vibration and swing out reduction. Here I'm having a simple two-axis system with two ELEX EX50 F20. First of all, we need to connect to our CNext over the web browser. If you are not sure how to connect to your CNext, please watch the video, which is linked in the description, where we describe to you how to connect to it. After the web motion is started up, the first thing we do is we are going to do a factory reset on both axes. Therefore, you go to the by command line and type in RES for reset. After this is done, we need to set the payload on both axes without turning them on. Therefore, you go on to the state controller and type in the weight. On the vertical one, we only have the ELEX F50 on it. The weight you'll find on the data sheet. So this one weighs 630 grams. With the cable, has also a bit of resistance and weight, we're going with 650 on it. The payload, you can imagine it as it's a feed forward, and it's like if you're having a car with a heavy trailer on it, and you know you need to press the gas pedal a little bit more at the beginning, instead of just slowly increasing it. And that's the knowledge we give to the axis with that. And the gain position, we have the auto gain button. The gain position is how aggressively the motor will control to a certain position. So if you're going up with the gain position, the system will be a bit more precise, but also it will lose a bit of stability. With the auto gain, we have a stable yet a very precise system. We are going to do that for both axes here. On the horizontal one, it's very easy as we have no additional weight on it. We just go with the default values. What we also have in the state controller here is the deviation, pause and target. That means if the deviation is higher than 2000 increments, which is 2 millimeters, the axis will turn off and a flash with the error 50 have it as it is an error. After these two values are set, we're going to reference firstly all the upper axis just to have them turned on. And then we are going to tune the lower axis. Always tune from lower to upper axis. So we're going to firstly tune the vertical one, horizontal one, and if we would have here another z-axis, we would then tune this for the last. After that, we are also going to reference the vertical one. And to tune it, we're going to do a repeat reverse motion for the whole stroke with a weight reverse to see if it's also stable in standstill. As you see, in this system, in this case, we do not need to tune it any further than the payload and the gain. The same thing we are going to do with the second axis. We're going to do a back and forth movement over the whole stroke with a weight in between. And as you see, also this is not a problem in this case. After that, we are going to move both axes simultaneously back and forth, but a bit slower. So we have the chance that each position of each axis will be reached at any time. So if there's a vibration going on at a certain position, we will see that. But as you see here, it's not that. In this case, it's not vibrating, it's a stable system. We have also the advanced settings with stability and where you can choose between stability and dynamics. Usually we do not change this. We have the avoid vibration function where you can avoid a certain vibration. We are going to demonstrate it in a second. And also the swing out reduction. The swing out reduction is a function to use if you're moving liquids or anything. There's also a link in the description where you see how this function works. So in this case, to have a vibration, we are going to set a wrong payload to this axis. We are going to set it to 2,000 grams. Be cautious if you're wearing a headphone, it's going to make a little bit of noise. And then we are going to eliminate the whole noise with the avoid vibration function. So that's the noise. You can go to scan. So, as you see, the vibration was about 349 hertz, and we could eliminate it with that. As I mentioned before, it's only a demonstration. Please do not set the wrong payload and then eliminate any vibration with this function. So, these are the basic functions on how to set up our controllers. Do consider for complex applications, it's a bit different, and always ask for our support if there's a high application before getting frustrated with the vibration, as we have a lot of experience with it. And we can help you over remote or even just visiting you at your site. So that's basically it. The system is running stable. And in the next video, what we are going to show you are the TÜV certified functions for functional safety. We're going to show you how to set it up and how these functions work. Thank you very much and see you next time.